All right, now we have to see how to work with external IOs. In the last example, we have used AB as input and X as output, but in the local variables. Now we will use external IOs, which means IOs from my PLC trainer. So how to do that? Now in our project, we have no external IOs defined. So first way is we have to add external IOs. So if you see in our trainer, we have these external IOs, which are connected to my PLC. We have digital IOs and analog IOs, okay? So these are my Exio line F. This is the modules here which we can add. So right click this one. One way is you can see read AXLF devices. So if you click this one, this will go online and it says no device found. No worries. So double click this one and we come here, okay? Now here we have none of the device defined here. Like you can see, you can define up to 63 devices. So I will select my device here. So the first device which I'm using is digital input and digital output. So if you see there are a lot of, there's a big list. So you can just go to the category, digital input and output. And the one which I'm using is this one. So you will see this model number on your device in the PLCnext hardware. So I know this is the one which I'm using. So I will select this one. And that's how you have defined. That's it. Now my second module is analog. So I will select this one and I will go to analog input and output. And this is the device I have. So my two devices are defined here. And if you open this one, and now you can see your digital IO and analog IO. So if you double click this digital IO, you can see your device list here. Digital input 0, digital output 0. This is input 0, input 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 7. And similarly, you have outputs. All right, so now we will use these IOs in our program. And how we can do that? It's very easy. So once you have defined the IOs here, go back to your main logic and go to variables. Now here I will write, let's say, input 0. This is my physical input 0. And press enter. And this is my boolean. And instead of local, make it external. Now we are using external IOs. Similarly, I will write input 1, boolean, and also external. And I use output 0, boolean, also external. Sounds good. Now we have two inputs and one output. I go back to my code. And in this case, let's take now an OR block. Similarly, double click this one. And it was my input 0, this here, input 1, and this one is output 0. So I have defined my logic. And just to make it look nicer, what I will do is I will put some comment. So I can go to insert a comment. And I want to write local variables. This is using local variables, just to differentiate these two. And I can write here as well, insert comment external IOs. Okay. So you can also move the comment. That's quite easy. Okay, now this is my external IOs. Now what we have to do, we have to go to our main controller. And if you see here, it already shows you the IOs from this Exio line here. So now we have to link the PLC variable, which we define in the main, in the variables, like this, input 0, input 1, output 0. These are still variables in the PLC program. It's not linked to IOs yet. To do that, go back to here, and our input 0 was in 0. So select this one and you can see three variables which were in the PLC. So I will select input 0. Now this is linked to my external input 0, this variable PLC input 0. Similarly, this is input 1. And now we have output 0, which is this one. So we have three variables now which are linked to external IOs. So input 0, which was in my PLC program, here input 0, it's linked to IN 0 of external module. Similarly, input 1 to IN01 and output 0 to external output 0. That's it. That's how you have linked inputs and outputs. Let's download this program and see the result. So I will write and start project and it will You can see the status here, zero warning, zero errors. If you have some problem in linking, you will see the errors here, and then you have to solve it. So it is going to download it, and now it's downloaded. So this is the monitoring. I would prefer to open main task. So this is external IOs. You can see it's false, false, and this output is also false. Now I'm going to trigger the input zero. I will turn it on for my trainer. And you can see I have turned it true. And because of the OR logic, the output is true. And the output indication, you can see, I don't know if you can, but it's visible in this LED here. This is my output. That's my output. This is my first input. So when my input goes off, output also goes off. Now I will trigger my second input. And you can see the LED status for the second input and the output status as well. So that's how you can use external IOs in the same program, also internal local variables as well. This is another shortcut to trigger it. All right, so this was about how to use external IOs quickly in the program in the PLCnext using this PLC interface. I hope that's quite easy, and you know, you can just put the blocks, put the comments, write the local variables, and then you can link it to your external variables, and you can also monitor it here. Another interesting thing I want to show you is you can also have a visualization. So if you open this one, it says no recorded data available. It's a logic analyzer. So what I can do is I can go to my main logic and right click this one, add to logic analyzer, input 0. Also I will add to logic analyzer, input 1, and also output 0. So I have three variables in the logic analyzer, and I will click start. So when you do that, maybe I will do it like this, you can see the status of your inputs and status of your outputs in this logic analyzer. It's just a way to monitor the IOs in the PLCnext software. So if I turn it off, you can see the status. So you can see that now this is turned off. So this is a digital pulse. So now I will trigger input 0 again. Now my input 0 is on, which is the green one. You can see the color from here, and output is also on within 100 milliseconds. So this is the input output status you can see here. So this logic analyzer is an inbuilt facility of the software. You don't have to have an external software. You can analyze your logic here. It's much more interesting when you have analog values, which we will see in the next video, how to work with analog inputs and outputs. So you can see much better way how to visualize this analog value in this logic analyzer. It's really good for troubleshooting purposes. So this is about programming the PLC with external IOs in digital. And there are many, many commands here which we can use, and I will be using some of these in my future lessons, and I will explain you how to work with these commands. In the next video, we will see a small example of how to work with analog IOs. I hope this video is interesting, and I'll see you soon in the next video.